Welcome to the Satellite Hawks. Alright, let's do this.
Pill to take when somebody says that satellites could be fake, huh? But don't you find it a little suspicious that you can't find any real satellite pictures? It might be hard to be believed, but maybe we're all being deceived. Yeah, maybe, huh? Listen up. Well, if you think you see one up in the sky, you can't see it with the naked eye. A satellite is about the size of a car, at least 300 miles away. You can't see that far. Whatever those dots are to move in the night, I'm telling you there ain't no sign of life. Welcome to the Satellite Hawks, just another one of them NASA jokes. You give a five, your picture of a satellite, but now bring it up a bunch of that CGI. A bunch of cartoons all over the place. Search satellites in space. Yeah, type that phrase into Google, folks. But let me welcome you to the Satellite Hawks. Now, before all of y'all start getting pissed, I ain't saying that satellites don't exist. I'm saying that it's theoretically absurd to think these devices orbit the Earth. I've seen them hanging from big balloons. Even Google's doing it too now, man. Have you seen that? Yeah, go check out Project Loon. And every now and then a satellite crashes, but that information never gets to the masses. Cause then you'll find out how these things really work. They're just on balloons, man. They don't orbit the Earth. Cause once upon a time, one crashed in Brazil with a balloon attached to its steel. Welcome to the Satellite Hawks, just another one of them NASA jokes. You give a five, a picture of a satellite, but now bring it up a bunch of that CGI. With a bunch of cartoons all over the place, when I search satellites in space. Yeah, type that phrase into Google, folks. Let me welcome you to the Satellite Hawks. Satellites be in the thermosphere when the temperature up there is way too severe? How can that type of equipment survive? How comes those satellites aren't burned alive? I'm telling you, man, it's just a pack of lies. There ain't no orbiting satellites, because 99% of our communication comes from undersea cables and cell tower stations. And GPS is ground-based too, man. Go check out a system called LORAN. It's a military system for navigation that uses ground towers to track your location. Are you seeing it yet? Welcome to the Satellite Hawks, just another one of them NASA jokes. You give a five, a picture of a satellite, but now bring it up a bunch of that CGI. With a bunch of cartoons all over the place, when I search satellites in space. Yeah, type that phrase into Google, folks. Let me welcome you to the Satellite Hawks. You see, Tesla figured out how to communicate without the need for satellites in space. It's mostly ground-based towers, you see, and that's how you get your satellite TV. They've monetized what Tesla made for free with their fake satellite industry. It was Arthur C. Clarke that theorized these things, the sci-fi boxes with solar wings. Another Freemason, it's no surprise. They make science fiction and they monetize. They've stolen Tesla's technology and they get you to pay for your TV. Are you seeing it now, people?
Welcome to the Satellite Hoax. Just another one of them satellite jokes. You can buy me a picture of a satellite without bringing up a bunch of that CGI. Just a bunch of cartoons all over the place. When I search satellites in space. Yeah, go type it into Google right now. And let me welcome you to the Satellite Hoax. So next time you see a photo of the Earth from space, look for satellites. You won't find a trace. Oh, they must have disappeared, I guess. Can't even see any from the ISS. If you want to have yourself a little enjoyment, go watch a NASA satellite deployment. Oh, man. And let me welcome you to the Satellite Hoax.